In our newsroom with more.
For a sense of the mood at McConnell's campaign headquarters, we turn now to Paul Kane of the Washington Post, who's there and joins us. So you've listened to Mitch McConnell's remarks. Were they conciliatory, confrontational? One of the quotes that kind of stood out to me, and I didn't have a chance to hear the whole thing, was, "I don't expect the president to wake up tomorrow and view the world any differently than he does now. He knows I won't either."
Exactly. McConnell did a little bit of both tonight. He did sort of some reaching out, some like softening up himself. He brought Dr. Noelle Hunter on stage and talked about how he helped get her daughter back from West Africa after her husband had abducted her. And then he also talked about his bipartisan efforts in the past. He didn't mention Vice President Biden by name, but he said at one point, you know, "I hope the president gives me the chance to do that again, to do deal making." But boy, there were also some big, big partisan jabs that he threw at this White House. And at the very, very end, he turned it back to Mitch McConnell, the fighter, Mitch McConnell, the partisan that Democrats have always loathed so much. And at the very end, it was, "This experiment in big government has lasted long enough." So really, Harvey, he did a little bit of both tonight.
Okay, you've been following the campaign for the last few days. What was the turning point? What was he able to use to motivate so many people to get out there in this decisive victory?
You know, he really, really used President Obama incredibly effective as his foil. He just said over and over again, "Obama needs Grimes, Kentucky needs McConnell." That was a line that he rolled out for the first time at the Fancy Farm Festival in southwestern Kentucky back in early August, and he just beat it into the ground over and over again. And in so many parts of Kentucky, President Obama is really unpopular. The coal country in eastern Kentucky, which has just been ravaged with thousands and thousands of job losses, McConnell is winning by margins that he's never won before there, and he's winning some counties that he's never won before, because those are really old Democratic counties in the sort of the last part of the South that really hadn't flipped. Well, those counties flipped tonight, and largely because McConnell ran against Obama.
Right, so was he able to make that case that there's this opportunity here, if the Republicans take the Senate, that one of the most powerful people in all of Washington would be from Kentucky?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was the other thing that he really did. Democrats like to say that in the last three or four election cycles, they've really localized their races, made people have a sense of what their incumbents are all about. McConnell, in this race, over and over again, part of his stump speech was the part where he talked about the rare opportunity to have your home state guy be the majority leader. And he made it clear that it would help Kentucky, that he would be delivering votes to help the coal industry, that he would deliver the Keystone Pipeline, which, while it doesn't cut through Kentucky, it is something that they're familiar with here. He really made that sense of the connection of, look, this is going to be pretty good for Kentucky if we have me as majority leader.
All right, Paul Kane of the Washington.